I see you finally made it here yourself. The city hanging in the air is slowly crumbling. What an incredible place we find ourselves. But that aside, you're certainly a force to be reckoned with, eh? I doubt there's a single soul who could have handled that giant other than you. It was practically a god. Of course, I count myself, the great Alexander, among many. Which means I've but one thing to ask of you. Would you kindly undertake my ordeal? Come and tell me when you're ready. I've been longing to fight a warrior as accomplished as you. You are ready then, I take it? Then let us begin.
I am the great Jar Warrior, Iron Fist Alexander. Lend me strength, O warriors. Let us become one champion together. I am the great Jar Warrior, Iron Fist Alexander. Lend me strength, O warriors within. Let us become one champion together.
Victory was impossible. This vessel was found lacking. My thanks. I knew you were the stuff of champions. It was a marvelous battle. I implore you, take what I bequeath from inside me. All vessels are destined to one day break. But the great Alexander lived as a warrior to his last.
Thank you. Ah, you. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think.
You burned the Erd Tree, didn't you? Then the Round Table is soon to follow.
Ah,
no need to fret about that. The Round Table holds served to put a tarnished upon the throne of Elven Lord. And if the Erd Tree needed to burn for that to happen, then the Round Table must go as well. You've already heard. Indeed. It seemed the whelp harbored suspicions, so I had no further use for her. Honestly, what's a man to do? A determined plebeian is more wicked than an omen horn, quite frankly. I suspect that's just what the Queen wants. A dose of ambition to incite the tarnished. Is that potion what I think it is? Bloody Celebus. I suppose he's up to something again. Oh, I won't interfere. You go ahead and do what you must. The Round Table has no code to speak of. But I ask you this. Are you really going to do the bidding of that twisted dolly botherer? Or would you rather hand that potion to me and see if we can't get one over on the bastard? Good. I'll dispose of the potion myself. You go and see Celebus, but don't give anything away. Just tell him that you tricked your mark into drinking the potion, as planned. Despite knowing next to bloody nothing, he's so far up his own arse he won't suspect a thing. His inevitable display of arrogance will certainly be a sight to behold.
Ah, you. Please, leave me be. It's pathetic, I know, but I need to think. So you know already, do you? Right. It's true. My father cast me out for indulging my emotions, forgetting the mission. Punishment for offing his pawns. Father, mother, Lord Gideon has offered me guidance all my life. I would have done anything for him, to place him on the throne of Elden Lord. And yet I, though it was not my intent, I betrayed him. And I can no longer trust in Father. To think he'd order his men to enact such tragedy. Where is the justice he purports in that? He once told me that if he became Elden Lord, he would never allow the downtrodden to be cheated ever again. Was he simply lying to me? No, no, no. How could I say that? Father has always given me his guidance. And now, I've lost it. Is that ash? I can smell the ancient storm in it. My thanks. I'll gladly take it. I'm not like Roderica. I don't feel the presence of spirits, let alone see them. Still, this ash, it reminds me of my first hawk. Thank you. In this ash, I can smell the ancient storm. It reminds me of my first hawk.
of death is unbound. And the lands between are shrouded by death's dark fate. But the flames will also burn the impenetrable thorns. Farewell, it is then. You'll be Elden Lord yet.